Tell me, what's happening to you, Harmon?
Leave me alone. Oh. I want him to go to bed. Go to bed, Harmon.
Go to bed.
Raymond, you tell me what's happening to him.
Right. Leave him alone.
I want to know what's going on. What is it?
Sit down, Flora.
But I want to see him.
You will. But I don't want you to wake him.
Small message of reassurance to that horizontal young lady. Don't despair. Help is en route. It's coming in an odd form from a very distant place, but it's nonetheless coming.
Submitted for your approval, the case of one Miss Agnes Grepp, put on earth with two left feet, an overabundance of thumbs, and a propensity for falling down manholes. In a moment, she will be up to her jaw in miracles, wrought by apprentice angel Harmon Cavender, intent on winning his wings. And though it's a fact that both of them should have stood in bed, they will tempt all the fates by moving into the cold, gray dawn of the Twilight Zone.
A word to the wise now to any and all who might suddenly feel the presence of a cigar-smoking helpmate who takes bank books out of thin air. If you're suddenly aware of any such celestial aids, it means that you're under the beneficent care of one Harmon Cavender, guardian angel. And this message from the Twilight Zone. Lots of luck.
Osborne, I wouldn't lock you in a trunk.
What are you? Where are you? Terry.
Thank you.